What would it feel like if you could handle the dreaded low forehand? Well, in today's video lesson, I'm going to break down how you can handle the low forehand, whether the ball's in the middle of the court or the ball's out wide. And there's a special concept that you must focus on that, again, I don't hear a lot of coaches talk about, and I want to break it down for you so that you can keep improving with this low forehand today. My name is Jeff Salzenstein. I'm the founder of Tennis Evolution, former top 100 ATP pro. I'm also a USPTA elite professional and a USTA high performance coach. And why do I tell you all that? Because, not because for me, but for you. I want you to know that I've been in the trenches, I've gone deep with this, and I want to help you. And today we're going to break down the low forehand. I really don't think you're going to find this level of detail or expertise anywhere else. That's why I'm here, to give you the real substance, the behind the scenes, what's really happening, breaking it all down for you so you can go out and practice and improve. And guess what? You can improve your low forehand without a partner on the other side of the net. I'm going to reveal how and why today. Now, the why is that you get a lot of forehands that are low and you're probably struggling with it. And there's a good chance when the ball's in the middle of the court and it's low, you're down here and you might even be lunging for the ball, or you might be getting set and reaching for it. Maybe you're mishitting and missing too many balls in the net. You're also probably getting wide balls that are low in this part of the court, particularly in doubles, but even in singles as well. And you're hitting and you're reaching and you're off balance and you're just not getting enough on that ball, and they're running you to the other court. Maybe you're not even making that ball and you're getting run to the other court. Maybe you are running, making that ball, and then you have no chance on the next ball. Well, we got to figure out how you can move to this ball and swing correctly. When the ball's in the middle of the court coming right at you, what I teach is what's called a karaoke footwork pattern. And so when the ball comes low, you want to hit it off your front foot and you want your knees bent. I know in another video I've talked about how you don't want to bend your knees on your forehand. The low forehand is definitely a time where the knees are going to stay bent and you're going to be pretty low. Okay, because the ball's low. You've got to get down to the level of the ball. All right, but make sure that when you hit this ball, you're not popping up or you're losing your balance. We have to teach you dynamic balance, dynamic movement. So when you hit this ball, as you're hitting it, I do what's called a karaoke footwork pattern. Again, this is a ball right at you. Front foot, swing, this foot comes behind, and this foot comes forward. Watch again. Front foot, behind, two, one, two, three. It's like a dance move. One, two, three. Okay, you want to see it with a ball? You're not going to get this forehand a lot, but again, you can be aware of it. It's low, one, two, three. Okay, so instead of being here and swinging, use some dynamic movement and flow through the ball when it's low. The lower the ball, the higher the ball, the more that we move through shots, okay? We don't stay static. We don't get set here. We don't get set here. That's a golden tip right there. Move through your shots when you're under stress. This is the difference between being at this level and this level, is movement. Closing that gap is the dynamic movement that I can teach you. So I'm glad that you're here today. Thanks for joining me on this journey in today's lesson with footwork and the low forehand. The wide forehand, when it comes low, what do? We run over to the ball, and instead of hitting off of the front foot and reaching, we learn to open up our stance and hit it off of the outside leg. So we measure our steps, and we keep our knees bent, we keep our body low, and we move over, and we hit off this leg. Do we hit and stop and go open stance and pivot? No, we move through it, especially when we're somewhat on the run. So we come up, we hit off this leg, and we keep moving like this. Remember my one, two, three on the karaoke? One, two, three. Wide forehand, watch this. Come up, what's my one? This is my one. One, two, three. Three steps. There's something to this, isn't there? It's not random. Okay, what I'm teaching you is very choreographed and calculated, because I would let everyone just move the way they naturally needed to move if people did it correctly. But they're not. because I'm watching players move on a tennis court. It's not efficient. The days of saying just move your feet are over, everyone. Let me say that again. The days of just saying move your feet are over. Tennis coaches all over the world have been telling you this, right? Just move your feet. No. You have to understand how to move your feet. And I've studied this game for years to be able to be in this position right here in this public park in between the lines teaching you. No fluff, no music, no choreographs, no sideshow lights. This is the real stuff right here. If you want real, you're in the right place. If you want fluff, if you want surface, go somewhere else. This is the depth right here, the depth of learning. Committed to this, okay? I'm committed to helping you. So the ball comes low and wide. Did you see what I did? I did it in slow motion. I mean, not slow motion, but I did it pretty slow. Watch my outside leg. One, two, three. You can count it out. One, two, three. One, two, three. Now, to break this down even more, my one, and then I swing, and as I'm swinging, this foot is crossing over. So this foot is not down when I'm making contact. If it is, you're probably gonna lose balance. You still can get away with it, but we go one, we swing, and then two is after contact, and then three is our square up so that we can push off and get back. But we're staying low the whole time. Our head is staying low. Our head is staying at this level. It's not popping up. I see players reaching and the head juts down. I see players reaching and lifting up. Keep the head level. That's how we move. Keep the head level on the low ball. Knees are bent, head is level. Does that make sense? I hope it does. I just wanted to be absolutely clear with you today with the details of how to handle a low forehand. I gave you a snippet of the middle ball. I gave you a deep dive into the wider ball. You're gonna see that in doubles, moving up to a ball. You're gonna see it in singles against the pusher that slices you short. You start handling this ball, your whole game is gonna open wide up. That's exciting, right? The low forehand. Guys and gals, I hope you enjoyed today's lesson today. I've got more for you. This is only the beginning. Obviously, I've got more videos on my YouTube channel. Make sure you subscribe. Turn those notifications on so you can be updated on more deep video content that's coming your way. Deep learning. That's what I'm all about. Deep, deep learning. But there's more. Let's keep going on this journey. Let's take action. You're an action taker. You're still here. I've got a free gift I want to offer you. Three forehand myths that players are making and coaches are teaching. No more. I want to end this. I want to have us catapult to the next level. There is so much more in store for us on this journey together. Click the link in the description below to learn the three forehand myths players are making. You can also click a link somewhere in this video. You're going to get those free free three forehand myths. That's pretty cool. I got through that, barely. Along with the solutions that come with it, click the link in the description or somewhere in this video. We'll get you the myths for free. We'll get you the solutions for free. You're going to go on that deep dive with me on the forehand. By the way, I can teach this on the backhand, the volley, the serve, footwork, strength and mobility, flexibility. We've got it all for you at Tennis Evolution. Thanks so much for your time today. Click that link in the description below. Let's get started going to the next level. Thanks.